Hello and welcome to the Orlovsky Consulting GBR presentation. My name is Alexander Orlovsky. I am CEO of this company. Let me introduce services of my company, what we are actually doing. We have experience in software development, quality assurance. We help clients to understand the requirements of their projects. And we have even some game dev developers on my team. So here's a disclaimer. The presented information based on circa 5,000 interviews with German companies, and this is not a book knowledge, so it's real experience. So today topic is as follows: why software projects fail in 2021? As you recently experienced outage of Facebook, Instagram and WhatsApp. So why big companies fail in their projects? And here I present main things which I have observed personally. So first of all, as you know, many software projects are very complex, and what I experienced and was my colleagues experience that initial design does not work with new requirements, and you have pretty complex situation where it's hard to test and hard to verify how exactly it works, but it's possible. Another reason is very strong dependencies on cloud providers. So today we have a lot of cloud providers which have pretty cool services to offer, but at some point their costs, hidden costs of running in production are pretty high. So you should expect that if you have usage of cloud services, you know what you're doing and you're able to verify and monitor the costs of running apps in the cloud. But this is a major point which I have so many times, that people, developers, just use the cloud and they don't think about the hidden costs. Another reason: difficult communication between developers. So in today modern world, we have developers in Far East and in Europe, and there are some time differences, and this time difference can be a challenge, and it can cause inability to react fast enough to the change of the requirements or the problems which arise in the software during the runtime of the apps. So another reason which I have so many times, it's broken business promises to deliver on time. Many German companies, they're working for the bigger clients, and they are unable or unwilling to communicate the complexity of the software development to their clients, to the bigger clients. And sometimes it's even worse, the lack of workforce to complete the project. And it's naturally that such project just delays, and bigger clients are not happy about. Another point which I want to speak about: lack of automated testing. It's kind of amazing how many companies still do software development without any automation tools. I mean, some companies just saying it's common practice and we have worked in such mode for the last 10 or even more years. And I was like really amazed how they able to even to deliver such software. And it's can be a potential challenge to complete the project anyhow. And what about waterfall? Yes, many German companies still rely on waterfall, and they do not understand that it is outdated workflow model and really very inefficient, because it is expected to finish development and testing on time, and if you have some difficulties to do that, the whole project pipeline just happens to slow down, and even to the point where it is not further maintainable, and higher ups and managers just do like really crazy stuff, and they demand from developers to do work over time, and after that many of them just burn over and not willing to work further for such company. So it can be for 5 years stable maybe, but after 5 years you will start to see some problems with running waterfall in your company. My best advice: estimate your current state and try to derive from that better plan so that you can transit to even better workflows, which allow your company to be pretty stable in what you're doing. Because if you don't do that, worse things definitely will happen. And another interesting stuff which I observe and which can cause actual software failure, it is wrong hiring plans and strategies. I have spoken to so many managers just saying, we need more developers, we need more developers. Well, if you read this book, this is pretty old but pretty famous book, The Mythical Man Month from Frederick P. Brooks, well, then you probably will know or have pretty good understanding that hiring new additional devs would not speed up the project, it actually slowed down the project. And software development is not a car production line. Whoever sold you such idea, they are basically wrong about. So software development is not a car production line, and I just recommend here to think about what you're trying to achieve when you hire new people. If you have very chaotic and problematic workflow where you have too much overtime for your workers, for your programmers, then hiring a new developer basically will not solve this problem. It definitely would bring problems into your team, because new hire need to be trained and need to be integrated in the team. And when it's actually take all in considerations, you will experience a pretty risky situation where a new hired person can cause a main malfunction into your software, and you will not be able to quickly and rapidly recover from it. So think about this. So another point which always is important to which I want to say it's always causing the project to fail is not realistic estimates. So basically you have somebody who did estimation like 5 or 10 years ago, and all team works to this estimation. But as I said earlier, software development is not a car production line. You need to think about what your current requirements, maybe the previous requirements which were implemented are invalid ones, and you need to reevaluate what you have actually implemented to this point. And it is very important to understand what are real estimates of your project. I have so way too many times my consultants or I come to the company of my client, and I will start to speak with different responsible persons for the software project development, and then we always see this picture that one team knows that project it is in delay mode, and another team just want to push, because they have pressure from the higher ups, which they like demand efficiency at high costs. And what can actually happen in such state? It's basically one department will be very successful in what they are doing, but another one, like software testing, they won't, and this will cause in unhappiness of the end client of the product. Because if the software wasn't tested quite well, it will actually crash or will work not as user expected. So my best advice, do realistic estimates without playing the blame game. It is really important to have realistic estimates. And creating realistic estimates should be number one goal, and only then the second goal, really to implement the software as it is expected. Sometimes it does not cut. Sometimes you need to make sure that your developers doing the right job. And if you, after all evaluation of the data, see that you won't be on time and you won't provide the product which you needed to create, maybe it is better to say we're stopping the development and we're doing only the right work. So as I said earlier, you need to think about what you are doing as team, as a whole company. It is pretty crucial for your success. And can we fix all of that madness? I think it is possible. One of the option which I in favor of, hire external vendor independent IT contractor, IT consultants. They would help you to make realistic implementation plans and figure out why it didn't work for you for the last 5 or more years. Another point which is kind of pretty easy to implement, it is strong feedback loops, so that you have always in 2 weeks iterations a meeting, Scrum type or Kanban meeting, doesn't matter, but a meeting where you have in one half of 1 hour, like 50 minutes or 30 minutes, a discussion about the current state of the development. Some say it's a kind of general overview of the project state, because you have your dailies, but in waterfall you don't have such state. You need to think about how do you provide an honest and strong feedback loop in your IT department, so that you will actually know what's happening there. And some managers say, but we trust our developers, we did work like 10 years and always was in good shape and we were able to push. But I say it's maybe a very exceptional case that is work for you, but what I have personally experienced, and I know how it happens in the practice, that you can have such situations that all team members say that we are going on time, but in real life you have always outside forces which can influence the project. And I have personally experienced that all team experienced seasoned senior developers were wrong, and my estimates were pretty accurate. So it does not help to have 100% trust in your developers. You need to have somehow gather the data and estimate the data and able to predict what will happen next. Then I will say it is important in 2021 to start to develop software through the testing during the development, then later into production. You need to have some sort of automation for your software which you're creating in the company. It is very important, because as we see it earlier, the Facebook was unable to run their production for like one or two days, depending where you are in region of the world. But they were unable to have a stable application. Why? I think they were not able to test complex application which they created like 10 years ago or even more. And I say another point which can be very easily solved, it's hiring policy of new developers. It's so big pain for me to see that how much pressure new junior developers get from the more seasoned developers. It's quite not understandable why they putting the developers under the pressure, because new developers must be trained. Well, you can train the new developers on job, and it would cost you the speed of the implementation of your project or maintaining of your project, or you will not be able to train them well, and you will have at some point of the development of the project big problems. So you need to, if you hire new developers, you need to train them before they actually go into the real project work. You need to train and prepare them. And if you just throw them away at the project, it's probably a bad idea, because it will cause problems. And if you don't have unit testing framework or unit tests, the new developers basically were not able to make it safely into development of your project. So it is 2021, it is now, you need to establish a routine for creating unit tests for the software models which you have. It can be complicated, it can cost you even more time, Yes, it is like it is, but you need to do and pay the price for not doing the testing first in your project. I'm pretty sure this more seasonal and senior developers would not disagree. They will say, we have legacy, we have no time for doing that. I say, good luck. If you don't do your tests, in 5 or 10 years, breakage and deprecation will happen to you. But it is important to think about how you go from here to the future. And you need to evaluate on constant basis the market, not only the how you develop your the project. You need to on constant basis to evaluate what you're actually doing and is it really what clients expecting to see in the final product. I have so many times that a company is spending a lot of time and end user just say, I don't need that feature, or why did you spend so much time on that feature? I don't need this presentation, or I don't need this visualization which you have presented, or the workflow has changed and now I don't need to do so many steps before I see actual result. And this is what another reason why I say Agile is very cool, and you need to have pretty clear understanding about what is Agile for you. Some companies just mix Scrum with Kanban, making by Scrum Band, but I think purity is the best thing which you need to achieve. If you want to have visualization of your workflow processes, use Kanban. If you need to put trust and be team driven, then you use Scrum. So you don't mix two different workflows, because those two different workflows have pretty different understanding on how to develop the project. Maybe it work for very seasonal and very senior people on very small teams, but in bigger organizations it's a bad idea, because you will have staff, as I said earlier, different regions, different dependencies, and I recommend actually to have a clear separation between regions. I mean, one region, developers in one region should not depend on the developers on another region. They should be able to develop their parts independently and only merge them with have a clear view of the contract. And the contract can be developed by outside contractor, which would be able to verify each of the involved parties. So another important stuff which I would like to mention, how to provide the solution. You need clear understanding on what you're really actually expecting from your team. It is kind of amazing, but once again, I have so many companies which are unable to have a clear understanding on what they're actually expecting from the teams. It is complexity which kills the understanding. So if business do not understand what actually software developers trying to achieve, you have a real problem, because if business is not in line with software developers processes and what they're actually doing, you will have a mismatch of expectancy. So it is important to understand what software teams doing, and if you're looking this from the business points, you have your clients, you have your estimates, and if the software developers telling you that we are not ready, you should listen to them, but you should be able to verify their claims. And this can be done with the help of the outside contractor companies, because we have both business and IT understandings. And if you don't do that, what I have actually provided to you, well, you will experience following problems. Adding new features will be always costly. You will be always over time, the developers will be overworked, and you will experience some problems. And even worse, the unstable code base gives you very high probability of major data loss or even security leaks, or even possible, I will say, problems that your software do some damaging on the machine of your clients. So think about of that. Then you don't have If you don't follow my provided solutions, you will have problems. A complete financial affair of your company. Because if you don't provide risk mitigation, how do you prepare if such event will happen? You need to have a plan if you will have like risk to happen. So I have even spoke with some companies and they tell you we have no time to do that. And I say, okay, but you still have to plan for the bad event and how you respond to that event. It's pretty important. And if you don't follow my advices, you will have difficulties furthermore with skilled workers to find. Because if you have very complex software stack, it will be pretty impossible to find somebody which have all those knowledges. I have so many companies in Germany, they're looking for people who have DevOps, who have front-end experience, who have back-end experience, who have even managerial experience. It is not possible to find such people. They're just not, such people does not exist. It's not, they are not, the different types of IT directions, they are not aligned with each other. It must be a pretty unique person, and I haven't seen such person in my experience with other companies. And if you think in terms of time, probably after this presentation, in 10 years or more, you will be able, basically will be pushed to deprecation of the software which you actually currently developing. Some companies tell me, like, in against what I'm claiming, yeah, but what about COBOL? COBOL still running everywhere on pretty important companies, and they are pretty happy. Well, yes, but their software accumulating so much technical debt that it's basically would be not be, they will not be able to do after 10 years in the round to do actual advancement of the software, and they would be pushed to the deprecation of the software. So maybe the ROI, return of investment, in such case will be probably zero, but it can be pretty worse for them, because if they have zero developers, they have zero understanding of what the software doing, they are actually seeing the procedures which the software doing, but after 10 years, workflow changes, requirements changes, and they will be pushed to the change of the software, and then they will just deprecate the software. And another pain point, it is, if you don't follow my advices, or just think about of that, it is actually pretty accurate that you will experience the production pipeline breakage. If you think about software like for packaging, logistics, and if you experience some problems with transmitting the data in your pipeline, you will experience breakage of your production pipeline. I'm pretty sorry about that, but this is the reality of the things which we must deal with. And in some cases, inability to change the software, inability to test the software, even produce a legal problem for the company. Like in case of the Facebook, we all saw that sometimes data leakage happens, and this is private data, and Facebook probably will have legal issues afterwards. And if you interested to work with my company, if you have any questions about what I have presented today, feel free to contact me via my official company website, or you can register yourself at the forum which I have provided here. And think about that it is pretty important to do the better job and to improve your business digitalization processes, and actually have a dynamic plan which allow you to have high probability of not taking the higher risk. And this is where we can help you. So feel free to contact my company. And thank you for watching this presentation. Bye-bye.